So it's the month of October, and just like we do it for every month, here are top 5 apps that you might want to try and install. And this is coming up. Hey everybody, Innocent here. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you are old here, thank you so much for coming back again. So coming up at number one today is an app called Launchpod. This app is here to help you eliminate the stress of going through that long list of apps before finding that particular app that you want to use. So basically, it provides you with the opportunity to launch your favorite app or any app on your phone by directly pressing the first key or the first letter of that particular app. So for instance, if I press Y right now, it is going to sort out all the apps on my phone that uses Y as the first initial letter. So YouTube is one of the apps, and then YouTube Studio. And then if you press on any other app, for instance E, it pops up all the apps. So you don't have to go through that long list of apps in order to search for that particular app that you're using. You can directly have it in your notification panel here. So the moment you launch it, it just pops up on your desktop and you can easily search for any app that you want to use. Now, additionally, you can add your favorite app to your favorite. So you long press on the app and then you add it to your favorite. And the next time you launch Launchpod, it will be the first app that you see on your screen. So I go ahead and launch this particular app, and then you can see that I have YouTube in my favorite. So you can easily navigate through apps with this particular Launchpod. At number two on today's list is Wallpy. So this app is a collection of the wallpapers of your favorite smartphone, the iPhones, the OnePlus, the Google Pixel, and any other phone you can think of. So for instance, if you click on OnePlus 7T right over here, it brings out all the wallpapers available on the OnePlus 7T. And if you go back, you can navigate through your Apple, your Google, and then your LG, HTC, and any other phone. These wallpapers are free. All that you have to do is you click on one of them that you want. So I'm using Samsung, so let me click on Samsung. So once you click on it, it brings you all the apps over here. So you can navigate or search through the popular ones that you can use over here. And then if you want to download it, all that you have to do is select that particular app, wait for it to load the full resolution, and then you can save it to your gallery, or straight ahead you set it as your wallpaper. So it's a very simple app to use. Additionally, you can go to the popular ones that has been downloaded by people. So from here you can see that these are popular phones: the iPhone X, the Google Pixel, and then the new iPhone 11. So these are popular apps that you can use to make your screen beautiful. Now, do you know that it can actually turn the screen of your phone to be more or less like the computer, specifically using Windows 10? Well, this app right over here called the WinX Launcher is here to help you change the appearance of your phone to that of a computer system, and that is Windows 10. So basically, this phone right over here is being changed to the appearance of a computer. Now if you go to this PC, it has your drives stored for you. So I have my local disk D and then C right over here. It's a very nice app to use, very simple to use. You can easily minimize this, or you close it using the close button. It basically functions like you're using the computer, just like Windows 10. So over here you have your network, everything, the battery life, and then the Bluetooth and everything that you can connect. You can still use that dial pad over here, simple to use. And then you might be asking, how do you connect with your other apps? So the Windows button over here will allow you to glance through all your apps that you can easily or quickly search through like that. So if you want to change the appearance of your screen, if you are bored with the launcher that you are currently using, you can at least try this particular launcher. You can set it as your default launcher and you can just use it for a couple of time and then switch back to your normal launcher. So that is it for number three, WinX Launcher. So moving on, at number four is called KWGT Widget. Now from the screen here, you can see that this is not the normal home screen of any Samsung Galaxy phone that you see. And that's because it has been customized with the KWGT widget. So this app is here to change the home screen of your phone. For nice and beautiful home screen customization, you might want to check out Quick View's channel. Link will be in the description. And for how to set it up, you might want to check up on Cyber Reviews as well as Rick Aqua. Links to their channels will be in the description. But then quickly, you download the app, and then on top of your home screen, as any place that you have just a small size, you go to widgets here, and then you can easily search for the KWGT widget. So you just type it KWGT, and then you have it over here. So you click on it, and then it opens the app for you. You can easily add any of the widgets. Now I've already added one, so what I have to do is I just click on it, and then it opens the widget for me. So this is the current widget that I'm using. Okay, so what I have to do next is I have to just click on the three buttons over here, go to the load presets, and then I can have access to some couple of other home screen setups that I can use. So depending on your type, you might want to go for any of these ones that you can use. This is the free version. If you pay for it, it has some nice widgets that you can use to decorate your home screen. So you just have to choose any one of them, and then you can make changes to this, and then you go ahead and you click on save over here. So right now, if I come to my home screen, this is the particular one that I'm using. It is very simple to use. If you want to give your home screen a new setup or a new look, you might want to consider KWGT widgets. So last on the list today is Alarmy. If you are somebody who finds it difficult in waking up for schools, lectures, and jobs or works, this alarm app is here to solve that issue for you. So this alarm app basically works like the normal alarms that we all know, but just a slight difference. It will require you, depending on how you set it, to set machines that will require you to solve that machines before the alarm will stop. So let's take a critical example. If I set my alarm to 8:30 right now, the alarm has been set already. But then if I click on it here, I'm able to go and add missions to it. So mission alarm, and at the missions we have that will require you to take a picture, shake the phone, solve a math problem, or scan a QR or barcode before the alarm will stop. Trust me, this alarm is not going to stop until you perform this action. So let's try with the math problem. It gives you three problems to solve, and then you can set how hard or easy you want this one to be. So for the sake of this particular tutorial, let me use the easy one. And then you click OK right over here. So when the alarm is due, you have to solve that problem before you can turn off the alarm. So let's wait till it's 8:30 and we experiment that. So now it's 8:30 and I want to dismiss the alarm. I've clicked on the dismiss, but then it requires me to solve this problem before the alarm will stop. If I don't solve this problem before this white ticking over here gets to the tail end, the alarm is going to repeat. So what I have to do is I have to solve this problem right over here, and then I click on the next one, and it brings the second particular machine that you are supposed to solve, and then it brings the third one that you are supposed to solve before the alarm will go off. So trust me, if you are a heavy sleeper, you need this particular app to control the time that you are supposed to wake up. You can add hard machines if you are a very heavy sleeper, and until you solve this machine, you are not sleeping. So that will be it for this video. Those were the five apps that I discovered in the month of October. I hope you liked them. Let me know in the comment section which one was your favorite and which one you're going to try it out. Also, let me know if you have any app that you'd want to see it featured in the next set of apps. Thank you so much for sticking around and watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Innocent here, and bye.